Welcome to the Void, my name is Liliana, also known as The Transfiendling, and today we're going to get back into Sonic Frontiers. I almost said Sonic Adventure because I was singing a song from Sonic Adventure a moment ago. But, a couple things. A, I was correct! I don't know exactly what the issue was. I don't know if it was batteries, or the connection, or what it was. Something was fucky with my controller though. I like did some testing and everything is just fine now. Watch it start glitching, I would be annoyed. But also, apparently this boss fight just, sucks. Because I talked to my housemate about it who played it, and it was just like, yeah, no, the night fight sucks. So, I did shamelessly look up, I did look up, you know, tactics to beat it, and apparently I was misunderstanding a cue, because I thought something that you're supposed to avoid is actually what you need to do to fight the boss. Is there, like, a sword to your nose? I just now realized that you have, like, a really, really big forehead thing. And then later you don't. So first off... You're gonna... Thank you. For a second I was worried you weren't going to fight me or take me seriously. Well, since you just did that... Oh gosh, you're just going to be... You're just gonna be a little... God. Let's see if I can do this in one take. Because I really just... That section, the camera angles suck. I don't know what's the deal there, but just that section's camera angles are atrocious. It is! It's your nose! Oh, damn. Can you? Okay. Sonic, I'm trying to... I don't know what this thing is. I will say, Super Sonic does have some issues where, like... He, like, doesn't do all of the button prompts don't quite work the same. Admittedly, it makes sense because, you know, you don't really have the dash anymore. But given that you... Well, you do. It's just weird. There we go. Boom! God. I like how this is just, like, a recreation of the fishing minigame at this point. Oh, the time of day changes on this one. Interesting. Okay, so you can't really... I don't think I can really change... I can't really seem to avoid those missiles. They just seem to kind of... exist? As in a state of, I'm going to hit you? Or if you can, the controls just aren't that great for that part. Love the game, this boss fight could use a bit more polish. Yeah, so apparently the thing you're supposed to do... Sonic, can you respond to my controls pretty please? Also, like, I don't know how I'm supposed to move vertically, because I can't. Oh! Okay. But yeah, so the thing that, like, I was, like, trying to avoid that I was supposed to apparently do is to, like... So, what you're supposed to do... God, I don't know. But what you're supposed to do is hit the, get in the red lines of the shield. And then essentially knock it back into him. Ah, come on now. God, even knowing this, it's really fucking hard, actually. Knight, circle back around. So I wonder if it, Knight, can you just actually circle back around so I can lock onto you? Alright, no? Alright, I'll just get in front of your shield and hope that you're lined up properly. Gosh darn it. Oh, come on, Knight. I do feel at least validated in knowing that, like, it's not just me. This fight is just bad. Oh, what the hell? Oh, for Void's sake. Knight, you... God, this fight does... Like, I don't enjoy saying unflattering things to a Sonic game, but fucking hell. And I can't control it either. It's just, I can like kind of vaguely send it back or vaguely change its trajectory. It would be wonderful if I could get it to do like lock on with the one circling around attack again. Are you capable of aiming it? Or I don't think I can aim it. It's just I can hit it. Oh my god. Oh no, I can aim it. Oh, okay. Which isn't really helpful given circumstances, but... Okay. Okay, I wish things were communicated better, because I did not pick up on the fact that you could aim this thing at any point. And, like, it is not, like... Oh, God. Again, I am having a good time! I'm loving the tunes, I'm loving the jams. This, in a very weird way, is kind of a bit nostalgic, because, like, it is a... Oh shit, is it just like I instantly fail? Yeah. Cause you know, this is a little bit of like weird nostalgia for like the, you know, whenever I was learning how to beat some of the other bosses in the other older Sonic games. I'm actually going to, if I can, gonna just go ahead and go back to where I had all of my rings so that I'm not going into this with, you know, a supersonic form with no health. Because I don't think supersonic gives you more rings if you die. At least the other sections, I don't think they did. Also, this episode might be really short because I have some things I need to get ready for this week. But I am going to do at least this boss fight and then do the egg mementos thing, whatever they're called. Since I keep forgetting to do those... And then remembering after, you know, it's kind of too late. Alright, we have seen this before. You are really cool, really intimidating, and you have some mechanics. Note, I'm not saying good mechanics, because I don't know if I can honestly say that. Okay. I will say, this fight was... ambitiously designed. No, what the hell? But that's about all I can really say for that's positive. Just because of the amount of frustration that I personally have with it. No. If it was just me, I would maybe not be so like, okay, come on. But if it's just a universal thing that, yeah, this fight just sucks, then, you know, there's maybe something a bit broken with it. Come on, send me your... Come on, throw me your frisbee fuckery! I will throw it right back. Well, not throw. More I'll, you know, write it right back. Because, you know, that's cool as hell. Though I am! Okay, don't get me wrong, I understand suspension and disbelief and whatnot. It did just suddenly occur to me. What is the logistics going on here? Is it just the sheer force of awesomeness allows Supersonic to control this thing? Because I don't know why else Supersonic is capable of actually, why Supersonic is capable of doing some of these things. Like, for example, controlling that massive shield whenever it was just a massive shield. It's not actually, like, a surfboard or anything. Can I get a... Oh, no, you swung your sword. I was trying to get a combo off. It's always sad when you can't get off what you're trying to get off. Haha! Die! If I could really get my, like, my chain attack off where, like, I circle him, that would be phenomenal. If nothing else, because that seems to do a boatload of damage. God, that is so, like, it's very, like, I don't have, like, also questions. What, other than just being a really cool light show, what was the point in all of that, like, the whole, the light show situation? Just because, like, can I? Yeah. Come on, come on. Yeah. Go, die. Ha ha. You're mine. I'm gonna murder you now. I have triggered your final cutscene. Which means it's time for you to die. Ha ha! Finally! I'm not given a button prompt just yet. Come on! What? No! I'm so confused. It wasn't giving me a button prompt. Are you fucking kidding me? No! Oh, are you kidding me? You're joking me, right? No, you're not joking me? Also, why is my button for, like, regaining things no longer working? Come on. Apologies if I get a bit quiet at some parts of this. I'm just wanting to get this done? Oh, What are you doing? Alright, come on now. What? Yeah, I know. I will say, one issue with the Steam controller, apparently. Is... Okay, apparently... Sonic just does not want to do his little fun rotating attack thing. But he wants to do that attack for some reason. Oh, I think I understand. I think it's that I have to get a hit in, and then I can use his projectile attacks. That's where the issue's coming in. I think part of the issue might have been I was trying to get screenshots, so it was, like, not sure which input to label it as. Yeah, your cool little frisbee thing. I also cannot skip this cutscene. I can pause it, which is kind of cool, but... I think he's going that way. Uh, Come here, pretty boy. What's going on? Am I attacking here still? I so don't understand what's going on. This does suffer from a typical like Sonic issue, like 3D Sonic game issues of the camera not being your friend. Oh, come on now. I'm trying to lead him. It's just the thing doesn't go far enough to properly lead him. There we go. Actually, can I just kill you right now? No, you have to do your funky little cutscene still. Alright, cool. Let's wrap this up. Haha, you're mine. Wow, and now button mash B. Haha! Get that shit out of here. Oh, this is so cool. I love this so much. Oh, this is very cathartic. Please let me grab the sword. Oh, no. That's fair. It would have been so cool, though, if... Oh, wait. Hold on. Yes. Oh, are we breaking the sword, or are we... Yes.
Oh my god, yes!
Yes! Yes! Oh, that's so good! Oh, that's so anime! Okay, fun fact about this, actually. Okay. Oh, that's so good! Oh, that's so good! I'm so happy, actually. Oh, okay. That was frustrating as fuck, but damn, that was worth it. Oh, that was so good! Okay. I need to geek out about something real quick. Something technical. So, you know, they did the trope that's often used in, like, anime and shit of, like, you know, the slash. And, like, you, like, see it for a second, but there's no, like, effect. And then everything happens. And, like, you know, then, like, the slow move and everything. That sort of trope originated as a glitch. Of the blood spurting on a delay happened because of a technical error where the blood tubes were over pressurized, so like they came out at a delay, then like all of it came out, and obviously there wasn't blood in this case, but it was still like a very similar usage of the trope, and that makes me happy. That trope specifically doesn't make me happy, but it's just like I understand how that functions now, and that's fun. Also, what the fuck is this shit going on? This is... interesting. Also, yeah, Sonic, how you doing? Aww.
The final lock has been revealed. Silence the six towers. Tear down the walls between dimensions.
Good. I thought you were gonna say there was a surprise Titan.
There is also a fourth Titan.
Hang tight, partner. We're almost through this.
Sonic, you look almost as tired as I feel. Are you okay?
Careful. Where's the fun in that?
Mood! That's why I play glass cannons. Always. Shut down six towers. Okay. So, we will get to that in the next episode, but I do still have something that I'm going to do on this episode. Not to, like, undermine the coolness of the boss fight with, you know, something less epic, but I do still have something I want to do because I'm curious what it will reveal about Eggman's situation. And if there's another way to view these, I am unaware of it, so I do apologize. But you view these things in the little fishing area, which is where you get all of the, like, where you get the egg logs to begin with. Hey, also, how are you existing here, by the way, Big? Like, I have questions.
Some force is keeping me from exiting cyberspace. Is it because my AI made unauthorized access to the databases? If so, that's the exact opposite of what it was supposed to do.
Thank you for, I guess, introducing us to this segment. So these are all, there's like 13 of these, I think. No, 24 of these. Hold that thought. But there's like, you know, there's 24 of these, and all of them are like just, you know, memo, essentially like, you know, note to self type things from Eggman. And I'm curious what it's going to tell us about his side of things, like how he, like what he's going through. Obviously, we see him, he's trapped in cyberspace, he's having a rough time, but I'm still curious about what it's going to say and reveal, and I'm real curious. I'm going to probably be quiet while they're playing just so that I don't interrupt, like I don't prevent anyone from hearing what's going on, but I'm very curious.
Some force is keeping me from exiting cyberspace. Is it because my AI made unauthorized access to the databases? If so, that's the exact opposite of what it was supposed to do.
Okay, so him finding out that he's trapped. Also, I just realized, like, the little UI for these things look just like the music player on my phone. That's kind of funny.
What a gun military craft doing in here? Sage has helped me avoid the worst of it, and it doesn't appear to be manned. Is it a defense mechanism? I need to learn more.
That sounds like it's related to the one, cutscene we saw where Sage was, like, telekinetically fucking them all up. I wonder, based on this, I wonder if it's, like, because he's trapped in cyberspace and, like, his mind and body are. I wonder if it, like, scanned his mind as, like, his biggest threats and manifested those. And Gun are, like the most common ones.
The terrain here keeps shifting. I'm finding recreations of regions from South Island, West Side Island, even Angel Island. Where is this environmental data coming from?
My thought is maybe, yeah, maybe it's scanning your brain.
I found elements from my own Eggnet, the United Federation, even planet Donpa Kingdom race data. As best as I can surmise, this cyberspace extends well beyond the scope of these islands and is gaining information from around the world. Fascinating.
That is pretty cool, actually.
I am officially jealous. This entire expanse was constructed by the ancient race who had previously settled on these islands. The level of technology they employ is completely alien to me, so I can't salvage it. Yet. It appears the Starfall Islands act as the CPU for cyberspace. Once I'm out of here, I need to secure them at all costs. I'm not able to access the data too readily, but it appears the entire history of the ancients is recorded here in cyberspace. More than that, they logged their memories, their desires. It's almost like they encoded their very souls into this place. Now then, how can I use that to my benefit?
Oh, Eggman, you are in fact a villain. So the planets themselves act as like the tower, if I remember right, or like the motherboard? I forget exactly which part of the computer the CPU is, other than, like, it's the central processing unit.
Who were the ancients? They predate any civilization by a wide margin. The Echidnas? The Black Arms? Please. The Babylonians? Hardly. And yet they didn't seem to influence the world beyond these three piddly islands. Why? What stopped them from conquering the world?
I mean, they don't really seem the conquering type. They seem like they kind of just wanted to vibe, but they were threatened, so they were defending themselves. At least so far.
I'm finding multiple connections between the ancients and the Chaos Emeralds. Their technology seems built with the emeralds in mind. It's almost like they share the same origin. I enjoy a good mystery, but not when the answers are more mysteries.
Mood.
The ancients seem to have employed a set of strange icons, or totems. That same imagery is being used by the Koko running around the islands. Did the Koko inspire the ancients? Or did the Koko adopt the leftovers once the ancients were gone?
Okay, so Eggman doesn't know that, like, the Kokos were, like, the hearts of the ancients or something. I'm still really unclear as to what that whole situation is. Because for anyone who isn't familiar, I'm going to hopefully remember. Note to self, Lily. 30 minutes in, do this. But like Chaos Zero, a character from Sonic Adventure, and then who appeared in the two-player mode for Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, Chaos's whole shtick was like he was like made of water and he was kind of like more squat than these ancients are, but his heart was a cocoa-sized, just nucleus-looking thing, and he grew out of control because he got fed a lot of Chaos Emeralds in the first game and yada yada yada. Well, the first Sonic Adventure game. Which also, this would, at least to me, would imply these are in the same continuity as Sonic Adventure, at the very least. I don't know how all the games are connected. But, it's interesting that, I'm guessing he hasn't found any visual data on the Ancients, so that's why he doesn't know that these look like Chaos Zero, but with, like, cocos instead of hearts, or instead of the heart.
Something wiped out the Ancients, that's for certain. A catastrophic event caused dire environmental shifts across the islands. It appears they made some effort to rebuild, but they were living on borrowed time. They died out within a generation.
That scans. We did see, like, weird, like, beams from the sky.
I don't believe this. I had Sage run a diagnostic for recorded genetic data of the Ancients, and then against archives I have with me. They're relatives of Chaos, the god of destruction.
The what
now? After countless years, their DNA corroded to the point they were completely transformed into a new species. Some kind of radiation affected them for eons, making them unrecognizable. Except to a genius like me.
Interesting. Also, Chaos has DNA? Or genetic data? And I did forget that, like, there was something about, like, in Sonic Adventure, it's been ages since I've actually played it, but something to the effect of, like, he was a protector designed to protect the Emeralds and the Master Emerald, and there was something. I didn't realize that he was, like, called the God of Destruction. That's new data to me, at least.
I'm deploying my most advanced artificial intelligence into the ancient network spanning the Starfall Islands. I've codenamed it Sage. Sage will take over the alien network, take control of all its resources, and give them to me. Once I'm out of here.
Okay, so it seems like these aren't in order. I thought they were. Like, I thought they just followed one another. But he already mentioned Sage in, like, this one.
I'm deploying my most advanced...
You know, he mentioned Sage in the last one, but now he's mentioning just here, like, just now that he's deploying it.
Sage is performing at peak efficiency. Makes me wonder where I went wrong with Orbot and Cubot. Not only is she taking control of the Ancients' network, but she's harassing Sonic as well. I love it!
I hope you love Sage, because I will murder you. I will find a way to murder the fictional, mimetic construct that is Eggman if you harm Sage.
Despite her best efforts, Sage can't seem to control the Titans. Phooey.
You actually said that word out loud.
Something is blocking her from assuming total control. Sage keeps running the numbers by me, and it's getting tedious. Yes, the power that wiped out the Ancients was formidable. Yes, unleashing it on this world would be catastrophic. But I'm a genius! Once I'm out of here, I'll find a way to handle it. Better yet, weaponize it against Sonic.
Eggman, never change. You are genuinely a villain. The arrogance of villains is just phenomenal.
Sage has been crucial to my survival here in cyberspace. Early warnings of hostile entities, guiding me past firewalls, keeping me updated on progress in the real world. She's the best. It's a program. An adorable program, a very personable program. I wonder if she has a preference.
Okay, this seems good.
I never really knew my cousin Maria. Everyone spoke of her like she was very special.
Maria?
Love for someone who was gone when I was right there. But I have to wonder. Back then, was she anything like Sage is now?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Huh. This is gonna get weird. I didn't expect to put you through a lot, too. Huh. That's... So, for anyone who's unaware, Shadow, he was first introduced, and kind of his whole shtick is, like, the... From what I understand, like... No. Hush. The one person who showed him kindness was this girl named Maria, who died in front of him, by gun soldiers. And that's kind of why he hates... Well, at the start of Sonic Adventure 2, hates humanity. So, the fact that apparently she was Eggman's cousin? That's at least news to me. No? Oh, gosh darn it. The UI interaction also is not entirely always efficient.
Sage told the funniest joke in a report. How fast can Sonic screw things up? Instantly, he's the fastest thing alive. I tell you, she's a chip off the old block. Well, for a program, I mean. It's not like she's alive. Or family, or...
I love Sage so much! That's amazing! That's hilarious! Okay, I'm really glad that Eggman seems to be, like, having the correct responses and treating Sage properly, because this is good. I love Sage so much.
Who says I can't create life, huh? It's a bunch of proteins pumping together. Anyone can do that. A true genius does it with code and electrons. And if I did create life, she would be brilliant and loyal and perfectly effective. And you know why? Because her dad is a genius, that's why.
Yes. Sage is baby girl, and you should treat her as such, because she's wonderful. Good, yes.
Sonic's on the island. Of course Sonic is on the island. I can't remember the last time I had a good night's scheme without him ruining it. Still, for a purely organic creature, obtaining Mach 1 of his own volition is impressive.
That's good. I'm glad Sonic has managed to impress you, Eggman. Damn, Mach 1, that is really fast. Is that sound barrier breaking? I don't recall.
It's Sonic who named me Eggman. Except the joke's on him. I embraced the name. I made it my own. His mockery is now a name feared across the ages. I'm not going to adopt Baldy McNose here, though. My dignity has limits.
Wait, hold on!
Wait, so your name legally is still Robotnik? You just changed everything as kind of like a... Oh my god. Because as far as I'm aware, we never actually got an explanation till now as to why it went from Robotnik to Eggman. There might be another reason, like a meta reason, like a... I don't know. Offhand, I can't think of any reason why Robotnik would, like, be changed for PR reasons, like IRL. But, you know... this is hilarious. That's amazing. That's phenomenal.
Here's Amy Rose has been dragged into the mix. Clever girl. Tenacious. She's come a long way since being an easy pawn in my schemes to ensnare Sonic. It seems like she had some trouble finding herself. But when you hang around with someone with as big an ego as Sonic,
or you.
Self-identification has to be a challenge.
Yeah, Amy has grown a lot, and I'm glad to see that she has kept that growth in this game.
Knuckles is here too. What a rube. That hair trigger of his is a problem, but also a boon when I can get him to go off in the right direction. Wait, if he's here, that means the Master Emerald is unguarded.
Oh my god, Eggman.
Oh, no, wait. I'm stuck here. Fooey.
Robotnik, you are a dork, and I adore you.
Sonic's here, so it's no surprise Tails is too. It's a pity. Young Prower has a keen mind and loads of potential, yet he's fixated on worshipping Sonic. And again, maybe that's for the best. Given all the trouble he gave me in Station Square and on the Ark, I think I prefer him wasting his potential lingering in Sonic's shadow.
Yeah, that's kind of fair. Yeah, I mean, for you, yeah, no, that's fair. Because I think Tails is probably honestly smarter than Robotnik. Also, Tails is only a kid. Like, they're all, I've mentioned this before, only canonically, like, teenagers at best. And Robotnik is a grown-ass man, and Tails is smart enough to rival Robotnik. And that is the last one. Yeah. Oh, that's fascinating. I'm... much more hopeful now for the, like, the future and ending of this game. I'm so excited. I'm so happy that Sage, that, like, Robotnik isn't just doing the general thing of being like, wait, I went to the wrong island. Oops. But Robotnik's just being like, oh, she's an AI. Why should I treat her like a person? Which is kind of what I was expecting her to do, which I was always expecting to, like, have to fucking loathe him. But he's actually treating her really well, and I'm really glad, because Sage is adorable. I do need to wrap this up. I'm going to just see how hard it is to get up the sides of one of these towers. It looks like I should be able to just dash up the side of it, possibly. Oh, maybe not. Oh, is each one going to be a platforming thing? Oh, interesting. Oh, shit. Okay, so this is going to be like an actual little bit of a challenge. Interesting. Okay. Oh, okay. I misunderstood distances there. Is that? That looks like one of the running walls. Can I just... Nope, I cannot. Noted. But yeah, I will say one thing. It has been the fact that, like, the angle kind of threw me off on that one. I thought I wasn't far enough, so I was trying to boost to get there. But apparently, I was already far enough. Oh, this is so fun. I'm so excited to figure out where this game is going to go. I'm also, like, very interested to see, like, what it brings for the future of this series. Because if we can get more of these, like, games like this, like, open-world Sonic games. Also, one thing that I'm uncertain how it's going to affect my channel, but apparently they are doing, like, there's more content that they have plans to release in 2023. So, presumably, it does say that there's going to be, like, more bosses and more story and more playable characters. So, I don't know if it's going to be, like, a Sonic Adventure 2 thing where every character has, like, their own unique levels and challenges with things. I don't know how they're gonna do it. I'm also really hoping they add Rouge back to the game, because Rouge is, without a doubt, and probably surprising no one, easily my favorite character from Sonic Adventure 2. Sorry, Shadow. There is actually a mod to replace Sonic with Rouge's model from, like, another recent Sonic game. Couldn't tell you which one. I might get it and, like, only activate it in my free time, but it looks actually very well done. Is this gonna be enough to power it down? Also, what is this thing doing? It's very unclear, because they look like force field generators at best. Chaos engines are harnessing the Emerald's energy perfectly. Finally, some good news. Hopefully, the power will be enough to let us escape. Interesting. Okay, so each of these is going to be a cutscene and getting some lore. Okay, so I am going to go ahead and... Let's see, is this going to, like, take me right to the next one? Kind of. It's not going to be an actual shortcut, though. Which is unfortunate. Oh, no. Alright, cool. Well, this is very exciting. I am looking forward to completing this game. I don't know how close to the end we are. I honestly don't want to know. I just am looking forward to the rest of this game and seeing where this story goes with these characters that I have known since my childhood. And it's really fun to see just how far this game has grown. Also, oh shit. Nope. It's fine. But, like, Sonic is doing real bad. So I hope he's doing okay. Until next time, I hope all of you are having a wonderful time with this. I'm having a blast. Even though I was frustrated with that boss, still having a blast. Please, do not forget to be kind to yourselves. If you'd like to help out the channel, please follow the Ko-fi link or the Tumblr link in the description below. Ko-fi, you can get subscribed to the channel, get into the subscriber-only Discord. Also, I have a bunch of other perks, like choosing games for me to play if you pay enough, choosing cosplays for me to do, and a bunch of other cool things. all on Tumblr. You can give me $5 and I will translate your name into Lighten You, my fun little demon language, show you what it looks like, and tell you what it means. And do not forget that you are very important. I'm eternally grateful for all my supporters over on Ko-fi, Daris, Sarah Senpai, Jinx Mutt, and Sapphic Serif. If you'd like to help support the channel, join the ranks by following the Ko-fi link in the description below. There, you can choose a variety of either one-time donations or subscriptions, which will get you the following benefits. Adding games to my list of things to play. Getting to choose cosplays for me to make Let's Plays in. Access to the subscriber-only Discord server. And much, much more. As always, don't forget to hydrate, masticate, and medicate.